Welcome, Internet. Are you ready for this? Today on this Bread to Loaf segment, we are going to be talking about dash cams and hardwiring them into your daily driver or other vehicle. Today, the vehicle we're working on is this beautiful 1988 Buick Electra Park Avenue. Great vehicle. This is, in fact, my daily driver. And this is the first part in a many long part series on this vehicle. So to kick things off, here's a short video to get you guys acquainted. Now that you guys are acquainted, let's talk a little bit about dash cams and why you should use them. Here inside the vehicle, I do have two dash cams. This is my rear dash cam up here, mounted right above the rear seats, facing out the rear window. And this one is already hardwired in, as you can see this wire sneaking down past this opera light. And this one is set to turn on when the car is turned on. So when the ignition is activated, this thing will turn on and run for however long the vehicle is running. And I have a 12 volt to 5 volt adapter buried somewhere down in the seat that goes up here and supplies power, and it's hardwired into the vehicle. Currently, my dash cam on the front is plugged into a 12 volt cigarette lighter outlet, and it has a little push button switch. Well, you know, let me just show you. So right here is the power going to my dash cam. It's this little push button thing right here, and there you hear it activate. So this is kind of a bad situation because, you know, if you bump this thing, the power connection is really, 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 really shitty. So we're gonna fix that today by hardwiring it, shut up, into the system of the car. So why might you want to use a dash cam at all in your vehicle? And I've got 3 points for you. Number one, insurance fraud. Number two, insurance fraud. Number three, capturing cool things on video. When that crazy alcoholic psycho down the street runs up to your car while you're sitting at a stoplight, throws himself on your windshield, and smashes himself bloody all over your front face, you need to have a video to prove that you didn't run into him and that he's a complete psycho. Don't believe me? Don't take my word for it. Just go on YouTube, look up dashcam insurance fraud, and you'll see plenty of videos of people throwing themselves on people's cars and claiming they were hit. Plus, when you see that cool accident or something awesome happens, like a meteor shoots across the sky, you can have video footage of it. There are a myriad of reasons why owning a dash cam in 2019 is a great idea. Now, if you're like me and you like things hard, well, today's your lucky day, because we're going to hardwire this dash cam into my car. And while I have you here, side note, check out this awesome leather interior in this car. Nice leather armrest, all these leather seats. So good. Sitting on them is like sitting on a pile of warm mashed potatoes, just cups the cheeks. But I digest. All right, enough of me talking. Let's get into it. Okay, first thing in my case is to remove the dash driver side kick panel. And in my case, these are 7mm. So what I'm doing here is, instead of using this push button toggle switch right here to activate the dash camera and other components when I want it, I'm going to be installing a rocker toggle switch, 12 volt, and I'm going to be drilling a hole down in my dash panel. That's why I'm removing it, and I'll be installing this upside down like this so I can flip it on and off and it will be semi-discreet. And since I want this dash cam to be on and off even when the car is off, I'm going to be hardwiring it into a always hot source, which in my case will be this 12 volt outlet, the wire coming up to it that provides positive 12 volt power. So before we get any further with this, I'm going to take out the fuse for the circuit. On this particular vehicle, the fuse that corresponds to the cigarette lighter is going to be number 11. So let's go ahead and remove that. So the overall plan is I'm going to be taking 12 volt power from the cigarette lighter, running it to the switch, and running power from the switch over to this piece right here. I'm gonna snip this part off right here, remove that. And then I'll connect it somewhere in here with quick disconnect so I can remove this entire apparatus if I want to. And then I'll be running ground wire from this end to a bolt on the car. And that should allow me to flip my dash cam on and off when I want to, even when the car is off. And then if I want to remove this entire thing, I can do that as well. Okay, first thing to do is we're going to cut this thing out. Give ourselves a little bit of room, so if I want to reuse this part later, I can. Now I'm going to go ahead and put spade connectors on these guys so I can quickly disconnect it if I don't want to have this in the vehicle. Dope. Check that out. This may get a little complicated, but I will be sure to put a picture up right here of what I'm doing and the electrical diagram of what is actually going on. So those of you sitting in your cushy armrest chairs at home, not in 25 degree weather, can follow along. So next step is I'm going to locate and drill the hole for the toggle switch. So I'm going to locate it, center punch the hole, drill out the hole with a small bit, and then go to final size with the big bit. So here are the materials. First locate it, then I'm going to use a center punch to mark the hole, then I'll be using a small bit to drill it, and then final size, in this case it's going to be a half inch drill bit. Because we are going to the diameter of these threads right here, and that's what's going to stick to the hole. Okay, and we're back, and as you can see, I have drilled and mounted this switch. So now let's run the wires. Okay, with the switch installed, now what I've done is measured and cut three lengths of wire. So we have one 12 volt positive going from the cigarette constant positive to the switch. We have another red wire going from the switch relaying power to my little unit over here and the dash cam. And then finally we have the ground wire going from this unit's ground wire to the chassis of the car. Okay, so I've gone ahead and soldered in the first connection. This is the 12 volt positive from the cigarette lighter, and it's going to the spade terminal that will connect to the switch. Okay, with that done, now I'm going to make the positive leg going from the switch over to this unit with the dash cam plugged into it. And that'll be pretty easy, just two female spade terminals. So let's get on with it. Okay, and finally we have the negative wire going from this unit to a bolt on the car for the ground. Again, this will just be spade terminals and an eyelet, so pretty simple. Okay, so here's the progress so far. I have all the wires run going up to the unit over there. We have the positive wire coming from the cigarette always on, and then we have the corresponding power feed going out to the hardline unit, and then we have the ground wire coming back and grounding right up here to this bolt. And additionally, I have added a ground wire coming from this third terminal and going up into the ground wire right here. And this just allows the light to turn on the switch. Alright, and there she is, everything buttoned back up. This is what it looks like. Turn it on, blue light's on, turn it off, and it goes off. And here it is over on the 12 volt power tap side. Turn it on, blue light comes on, dash cam comes on, and
radar detector as well.
Well, that's it for today's video. Hope you enjoyed. Go ahead and subscribe if you thought that was cool or you want to see more content. Smash the like button, and I'll see you in the next video.